The long road to recovery for Edwyn Collins now on BBC4 after a brain hemorrhage in 2005 interrupted the making of his latest album, Home Again.
When Edwyn Collins released the single You'll Never Know, the 28th in a career that began in 1980 and has seen him become one of Scotland's best and best-loved singer-songwriters, it represented one of the most remarkable comebacks the music industry has ever seen. Edwyn's musical career began in the early 80s when he fronted Glasgow band Orange Juice to huge critical acclaim. What
presents? They were just so fresh and young and interesting.
The complete arch and the fairness of it, as well as the great music, meant that guys could be utterly charming and utterly stupid and utterly intelligent all at once.
One of the best records to come out this year, that's Edwyn Collins.
Edwyn Collins.
Edwyn Collins with the excellent A Girl Like You. Well, I've never met a girl
like you before. After going solo in the mid-80s, Edwyn had a worldwide breakout hit in 1994 with the single A Girl Like You.
A lot of people were very, very pleased for Edwyn, who admired what he'd done, you know, and he was a good guy. And he hadn't had any huge commercial success up until then.
There was a bit of punk in there, there was a bit of Northern Soul, there was a bit of the Velvet Underground, there was a bit of Motown. He'd absorbed all these different brilliant bits of pop and put them together into a kind of unique whole.
In early 2005, while he was working on his 10th studio album, Edwyn's life changed forever.
I had a stroke, you know, and it's 6 months in hospital, and it's terrible for me. It's affecting my life. I couldn't walk, and it's true that I'm learning a lot of things, like brushing my teeth. It's tragic.
Do you remember before you were ill?
Vaguely. It's impossible to I don't know, sorry. Now I've reached this destination, but it's
funny, I don't recognize the sign. In February 2005, Edwyn had a brain hemorrhage, quickly followed by a second. Without an operation to relieve the pressure on his brain, he would have died. When he woke up in hospital, he couldn't read, write, walk, or talk. His wife Grace has been with him throughout.
It's quite surreal, I suppose, thinking back on it. They told us that there was a big risk that you would have another bleed. And it was a sort of waiting game, I suppose. That was the Sunday, and the thing we'd been hoping wouldn't happen did happen, and he had another bleed. Things looked pretty grim. We were met by a doctor who told us that they had decided to
operate
on you, love, yeah, and try to remove the bleed. So off you went. And as for your outcome, well, they weren't really making many predictions long term, but your life was still somewhat hanging.
What, on the balance?
Yeah. But we had, you know, from that point on, is, you know, it was a very, very, you know, it was all like the stuff of nightmares, you know.
In September 2006, when we started to follow Edwyn, his dysphasia, which ruptures the pathways between thought and speech, was making it hard for him to construct full sentences.
What are your goals for the next year?
The goals? To understand, to communicate with people, the necessary goals to read again, to write again, to be able to play the guitar. I don't know. Possibly. Here's my guitars. The Fender, the Gretsch, the violin, the Gibson, Epiphone.
The effects of Edwyn's stroke, in particular the loss of the use of his right arm, have serious consequences for his musical career, and he's not sure he'll ever work again.
My hands are tied at the moment. No movement at all. It's hard for me to concentrate on the guitar.
Do you think you'll write songs again?
Yes. I'm searching for the truth. I'm searching for the truth. Some sweet day we'll get there in the end. Some sweet day we'll get there in the end. The great Edwyn wrote that.
Too slow?
Yeah.
Too fast?
Yes.
Slow down?
Yes, slow down.
Certainly.
Your Highness. I'm magnificent. I don't know about you.
Hopeless.
Okay. Want to do it again?
Yeah.
I think I've been...
coping with it?
Yeah. I don't know. I think we're all right, aren't we?
Yes, yes.
I mean, it's weird. It's no doubt about it. You sort of... your life is... changed
upside down
totally,
yeah,
in an instant. But Edwyn says it, Edwyn, sometimes I feel, you know, you're sort of railing against the unfairness or something, you know, and Edwyn will say, I'm alive, and that's all that matters.
I'm glad I'm alive.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad I'm alive. Get on with things.
Upwards and onwards, I draw the
In an attempt to get as much of his speech and movement back as possible, Edwyn has started out on an intensive programme of therapy. He and Grace travel halfway across London three times a week for physiotherapy sessions with Ellen MacDonald.
Nice big steps in walking down the wrist.
Yeah.
Edwyn lost much of the movement and feeling in his right side after his two strokes. These sessions are vital if he is ever to walk easily again, and if he is ever to play the guitar.
So standing up through the right leg, really pushing through the right leg, heel down, bottom in. That's it. Good.
Well, I need to sit down, please.
When I first met him, he was mostly in a wheelchair and had a big splint on his leg as well. So we're at the point now where we're just trying to wean off the stick and get his balance a bit better. Try to straighten your arm with me. Go on, push me away with this arm. Go on, long arm. Good, go. All the way over here, reach. Oh, okay.
Sorry, Ellen.
It's all right. Your arm is doing beautiful things there.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's coming in with a balance reaction there. Difficulty with his arm is the sensation, really. It's always so difficult after a stroke because people have different parts of the brain affected and their recovery is also different. So we don't really like to put labels on people and tell them how far they'll go. As long as they're improving, just keep encouraging them and keep making them work as hard as they can.
The bells are ringing across London town.
Together with the formal therapy sessions, it's the constant encouragement of Edwyn's wife Grace that is helping his recovery.
So listen, was Ellen kind of tough on you today?
Tough on me? She's a nightmare.
I'll tell her you said so, Edwyn. We'll miss her when she goes back to Australia. What we do?
I don't know. Panic. I'm clear what I've got to do.
You're clear?
Yes.
Good.
In my mind.
Positive mental attitude. No fights, you and I. OK. Do you think that's possible?
I don't think so.
In the late 70s, around the time Edwyn formed Orange Juice, he was working as an illustrator in the Glasgow Parks Department. He has always drawn, but since his stroke left him without the use of his right hand, he has taught himself to work with his left.
And when I'm not so crazy about that, I'm not so happy about the goose. Now, this is more like it. The tiger I always wanted to illustrate. The tiger is brilliant to me. It's not in your
mind. Since he fell ill, Edwyn has received huge support from his fans, and much of it has come through his MySpace site that Grace and Edwyn's son William set up for him.
And we are thinking of you.
Oh, wonderful.
Friends.
For you, is a way back to your old life to talk to people about your career and your songs and the things that they write to you. You were saying that you feel that the people who write to you treat you with...
respect,
that's
yeah.
It.
Yeah.
Mm. And it's really kind, isn't it?
Yes, it is kind and appreciated.
He's kind of addicted to it. It's kind of taking off.
I'm not.
All right, so... in a way, you are. He always shouts to Grace sometime, computer, please, MySpace, please. Or shouts out,
No, no, that's not true at all.
That's not true? You promise that's not true at all?
Yes, I promise.
Oh, lie. but, that's just what happens, practically. He's a MySpace junkie, should I would call it. In a nice way, Dad.
I'll take a train, I'll take a plane, way up north where they know my name. But they don't bug me the way some folks do.
Edwyn has always had close links with the town of Helmsdale in Sutherland. He owns a house there that has been in his family for generations, and many of the songs he was writing when he fell ill are inspired by the landscape.
I came here as a boy, and I grew up here, and it's my home, and it's my life.
So I stood on the edge of my world.
In August 2004, Edwyn was filmed walking the Wallago Steps, 365 stone steps leading down a sheer cliff face to the sea. It's a mark of his progress that by spring 2007, he now feels ready to tackle them again.
I remember you were in hospital and I used to say, one day we'll get you down the steps.
Don't remind me.
More in hope than expectation then. And here we are. Going to try it?
Yes.
They're very dramatic, but they're quite safe.
Are they?
Well, we'll see how we go.
Okay.
Take time, let me get ahead of you, love, so I can take your weight. So. Right, let me get down first, love. Just a second, Edwyn. You're a monkey, stop.
What?
Just so I get stabilised here, love. Well done. Do you need a rest?
No.
Octavia, shout if I need a rest, OK?
Yeah. Yeah.
Get ahead of you, Alice. OK.
This is mental that we're here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you think we're mad for tracking this? There's where you used to stand out and show off.
What?
Down there in those rocks, and you go all the way out, give me the
heebie-jeebies.
I told you we'd do this, you were going, it'll never happen. You keep trying everything.
Yeah, keep trying and challenges ahead.
The immediate challenge, getting back up. Why don't you give me
the ghost of a chance? There are moments of great triumph, but more common for Edwyn is the incremental progress he is making day to day. Learning to read again has been particularly tough.
Heard the books. Boots and again.
It's a really shocking thing. Nobody had actually warned me or told me, and I took a magazine in that had an article about orange juice in it, and I gave it to you, and as you were looking at it, I thought, you can't read.
Shocking.
You can't read. And of all the different sort of shocks and things, that really hit me.
Hi, Trudy.
Hi there, how are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
The intensive therapy continues. 3 times a week, Edwyn is visited at his London home by his speech therapist, Trudy Jenkins.
OK, so let's have a look at some anagrams. So I'm going to try and use as much guitar knowledge as I have.
OK.
Which is all that I've learnt from you.
No.
OK, this is a type of guitar. See if you can spot the word.
For Fender.
Got it. Can you rearrange it?
Okay.
Does it look right?
No.
No. There's 2 letters round the wrong way.
Okay. Yeah.
Not quite. The other way.
Okay.
Fender.
Okay.
Great. Within your language areas, you have a dictionary of words which you use, high-frequency words that you would use every day to low-frequency words that you might struggle a little bit more for. So for Edwyn, for instance, his knowledge and vocabulary of any kind of recording equipment, his musical instruments, whatever it is that he would have, concentrated on a lot before, had a passion for before, would be much easier for him to work on now.
Edwyn's greatest hope is that one day he will play live with his band. Today, 18th of February 2007, he takes the first steps in that direction.
Life is God. Life is... I'm so happy to get there. The way forward is returning to me once again. Hi. Yeah, hi.
Right.
Yeah, wonderful.
Edwyn has practiced at home, but this is the very first time he has played with his band since he fell ill. No one knows how things will go, especially when it comes to his new songs.
Love is a lonely number.
Makes perfect.
I think his old songs, the ones that he was used to sing before, would be much easier for him. I think new songs would be a bit more tricky, but I don't know that they would necessarily be, he would be unable to do that. I think where there's a will.
Poor old soul?
Yeah.
You want to rock out with
him? Yes.
Already?
Back with a vengeance, march and folk, my friend, the harlequin, the
Roll. You couldn't have made your life more difficult if you bloody tried, could you? It's really easy words, isn't it?
I've forgotten the words a bit, but I'll get there. It's fantastic for me. It's really enjoyable for me. Why not sing?
Brilliant, actually. Yeah, I mean, he's really coming along, I think, you know, when you consider we talked about doing some music and singing a few months ago, and I thought there's no way he's going to be able to get it together for them.
All I'm saying is I'm
It's amazing, you know, after a couple of years, because we have to say we did wonder whether it would ever happen again. But I knew Edwyn would be determined to have a go, and it's great. It's just a few more practices, and it won't be long before we're out and gigging again, I think.
Children.
You can see the changes in the outside, you can sing, you know, you can be with his band, you can do all these things. But the real changes I feel that I notice are they're happening on the inside. It's about independence and seizing control again, and today is just amazing step forward in that.
Yeah, it's all right.
Five-second intro to that. Dave, Seth? It's now July, and the album that Edwyn recorded before he fell ill is finished and ready for release. The single has been chosen, and there's a video to be made.
This time a year ago, he was talking about retiring. And so that's clearly, you've got better and better sufficiently to have this urge to...
sing again?
Yeah.
Once more?
Yeah.
He's just walked that, OK?
OK.
He's very motivated to work. Well, you know, don't want to give the impression this is a bed of roses, because we fight, don't we?
Yes, constantly. Every day.
That bad?
Yes. That bad.
And here we go, good luck. And run video.
Video running. It's
black and white. Turn over.
Running.
Thank you, Lord.
Enthusiasm was kind of really inspiring for it today, and you can tell that he's excited and kind of his laughter is infectious, so it's good vibe all around in the crew, really.
It's pressure, but I enjoyed it. It's a good single, it's a strong single, it's a positive single, and I'm happy with the new Never Know My Love.
Back at work, and he's really, really, really enjoying it. He's really thriving on this. I think it's aiding his recovery. Keep checking that he's not feeling a bit knackered or
overwhelmed or and no, I think he absolutely thrives on it, and really it's just miraculous thing, isn't it? It's just wonderful.
First play worldwide of the forthcoming new single from Edwyn Collins, You'll Never Know.
2.5 years after suffering 2 brain hemorrhages that almost killed him and left him unable to walk and talk, Edwyn is back making music once more. But just before his immersion back in his old world, Edwyn travels to Helmsdale to prepare for the onslaught. Both he and Grace have noticed an unlikely indicator of his recovery.
Uh-oh. No? Okay, Mr. Independent, do you want me to help you, or are you going to do it yourself?
No, fine. I'm stubborn. Mm-hmm. I know what's wrong, especially with my album coming out.
Mm-hmm. You know what you want.
Yes.
And you won't be told.
Yeah, that's
the old you, for sure. You're back to being stubborn, which you weren't. So the great news is he's back to being cussed, awkward, stubborn.
Steady on, Grace. Good God.
So this is cause for celebration. Oh, it's beautiful. It's the first time your dad brought me here, Will. I couldn't believe it. The 2 seals followed us all the way miles along the beach, didn't they?
Yeah.
I thought, I'm going to hold this little moment.
Forever.
Uh-huh. I think I do have to stop myself looking back and think, oh, remember, if only. There's no going back. I just banish that stuff because we need to
crack on.
Yeah.
Are you the same person that you were before you had your stroke?
Not really. It's hard for me to touch the essence who I am once more, but I'm not depressed at all. 2 years on, I'm getting there, slowly.
What have we lost?
We have lost,
we've lost
everything.
We've broken all our toys.
We're naughty little boys.
That's one of your finest compositions.
What do you miss of your old life?
Nothing at all.
Again, hardly certain of my role, and then I started searching for my soul again, but there was nothing I could find.
Edwyn is planning on playing live in London before the end of the year.
Unwhole again, but I've been here before, old friend. And I know I'll be consoled again. In the past I've left behind. When I was a boy.
Stop, please.
That's not for today.
Why do we move on?
Okay.
step, 'cause there's magic in my eyes. I can see for miles and miles and miles and miles and miles. If you think that I don't know about the little tricks you play and never see you when deliberately put them in my way, well, here's a poke at you. You're gonna choke on it too. You're gonna lose that smile because all the while I can see for miles and miles. I can see for miles and miles. I can see for miles and miles and miles and miles and miles. Oh yeah. You took advantage of my trust in you when I was so far away. I saw you holding lots of other guys and now you've got the nerve to say that you still want me. Well, that says maybe, but you gotta stand trial because all the while I can see for miles and miles. I can see for miles and miles. I can see for miles.
Irresistibly seductive.
Ken slipped it to me between the hors d'oeuvre and the entree.
This one has a one-track mind.
Bewitchingly simple.
Well, this is nice.
Strangely compelling.
I must stop you.
Oh, my God.
What else was there to do on a Sunday in those days? We didn't have the clubbing and drinking culture that we have now.
Join the cult of Sunday, and the secrets of their success will be revealed.
Imagine it in front of Mother.
Continuing with Howard's Way, Sunday at 8:50 on BBC4.
What do you fellas do?
You're looking at the finest ad men in New York. Hell, the world.
Most of the time, they're looking for something between a mother and a waitress. And the rest of the time, well.
Advertising is based on one thing. Happiness.
When you've got it all. I cheated myself. You've got it all to lose. Like I knew
I would. Everybody on.
Now!
I
tell you,
I was troubled. Who is Donald Draper?
I guess I didn't ask because I didn't want to know. I cheated myself. How could someone do that to the person that they love?
I don't like to be treated that way.
I
The Sopranos comes the Golden Globe winning Mad Men, coming soon to BBC4.